Hi there, welcome to this PowerPoint quiz training course. Now last time, if you've been following along, we looked at how to take a quiz or take PowerPoint, make a quiz out of it and put the quiz online. Now I did promise you that this week that we would look at how to get results from people who your users, you know, answers to their questions, the questions that they answer, we want to basically recover their results. That's right, we want to take their results, allow them to interact, and get the results in an Excel spreadsheet. So how do we do that with Microsoft PowerPoint? And what's more, how do we do that online? So this is computer tutoring. Let's go to the da-da-da-da-da-da-da. All right, so hopefully I'm recording the screen now. You see my PowerPoint presentation in front of me. What I need to do is I need to add in these questions. Now, if you remember before that we did a series of buttons that we had the chow chow, this one here. In fact, if I just go onto the here, I've got like latest test. If I remember, that's the one there. Nope, it's not that one. Let me just close that one down. Which one was it then? For the love of animals, was it this one here? That's the baby. And we went here when we played this one, you decided on whether it was a Great Dane and it was wrong, you know, that type of thing. So it was, you know, if this is real or fake, it, you had different options there. So I think you remember that that one there. If I clicked on Chow Chow, it came up correct and went to the next one. So the trouble with this one is it's great for a bit of fun, but if you want to start to get users' results, you want to test them, maybe not on whether animals are real or fake or not, but maybe on whether, you know, and something a little bit more important, then this is how you do it, okay? So firstly, let's take this, let's close down that quiz. I'm just going to close that one down. We're going to go to this breed. What breed of dog is this? So we know this is a chow chow, okay? Now, instead of getting users to sort of just click on a button, we're going to use Microsoft Forms. That's right, we're going to use Microsoft Forms, put a form into this PowerPoint presentation, and then that will enable users to select the right answer. Let's get started. So what we'll do for Microsoft Forms is we're going to make sure we're going to go to Insert. Now, just one quick thing, just if you want to carry on with this, please make sure you've got Office 365 and Office 2019. So this is PowerPoint 2019. If you're in any doubt of that, if it looks something similar to mine, then that's great. If I just, and I've clicked on File there, if I go there, and then I go down to Options just down here. Account rather. You can quickly see the Office suite here that you've got, which is good. All righty then. So let's go here, and I'm going to insert another slide after this. I'm just going to click on Home just here. Actually, I don't know why I'm zooming in. I'm going to try and zoom in actually by using the just another feature, which is a way of doing it. It makes it a bit more smoother in post-production. So I'm going to click on Home. I'm going to click on New Slide just here, and I'm going to choose Blank Slide. And there we go. I've got a blank slide after the chow chow, after the dog. So now I can put my quiz in, yeah? So here I'm going to go to Insert. Yeah, and then I'm going to go over to Forms. So you can see this Forms section just here. Give that a click, all right? So give that Forms section a click. You clicked it? Good. All right, so let's click on that. And over on the right-hand side here, I can see a list of my forms that will appear. Also, let's just load them up. There we go. So over here on the right-hand side, you can see the forms. I've mucked around with a few of these ones beforehand, so you can see for the love of animals is there quite a few times there. In a future video, in a future tutorial, I'll look at how to take all of these forms, which will be separate in this tutorial, and then bring it all together. Doing this, there's an easy way and there is a hard way to do this. So we're going to do the easy way, basically. So it's getting all of the information, putting it together in one form, and then collating the data from one form. And then we do it the harder way, where we can do basically forms after each slide. So after chow chow here, I can do a form after that. And then after this real or fake here, I can do a form after that. So in that way, it's a little bit more difficult to collate those results together, but I'll show you how you can do it. It's a bit fiddly, but I'll show you how you can do it in a future tutorial. So make sure you subscribe. Okay. Of course, if you're asking questions and everything, it all really helps if you're a subscriber, doesn't it? Because then you don't miss anything, if you have questions. All right, then let's get carry on with this. So I'm going to do a new quiz. Make sure we click on new quiz just here. Yeah, so we're going to click on new quiz. So let's click on the new quiz. Here we got our quiz here. It's actually opening up our browser and now going into Microsoft Forms, as you can see here with this cyan type view. So now I'm in Microsoft Forms. So let's carry on, shall we? So let's just call this here and I'm going to call this form the craziest animals. Okay, and then it just enter a description. Here is a little old quiz about crazy animals. Yeah. Okay. All right then. So now I'm going to add a question. So if I click on the add new button to add a new question in, this is going to be a choice question. And it goes, what breed of dog is this? Okay. Now I need to get a picture. Now, if you look at the button just over here on the right hand side, give it a click. And then it will go into your media section over here on the very right hand side. I'm going to click on image just here. I suppose you could do it. Oh, let's just click that again. Click on image. I'm going to go to my OneDrive. Just find my folder for leisure and then scroll all the way down and find my quizzes. And inside my quizzes, I have my dog and that should be, there it is. There's the chow chow. Click on add. And then that will add the chow chow dog here. That's great. I can edit this a little bit. Decide maybe to zoom in a little tad here. Let's just move that around a little bit. That's great. Brilliant. Okay. And then I'm going to do this one here. I'll put some options. Let's put terrier. Let's put Newfoundland. Let's add another option. Put in Dalmatian. And then let's put the right option here. Chow chow. Hope they're all spelt right. So you see you've got these little ticks just here on the right hand side here. That will allow you to let the user know, or that will allow you to choose the right answer. Because chow chow is correct. Let us click on that tick. That's great. That's the only one we need to do. We might need to sort of put some comments in if we need to, but there's no real need to do that one at all. At the bottom here, we need to decide on how many points the person gets for this question. So I'm going to click on 1 point just here, and it's not required. So that's great. I can go on to the next question. And I go on. So this one's going to be a choice. Is this creature real or fake? Okay, let's choose the creature by going to my image and my OneDrive, and let's choose my little owly, weirdy terrier type creature that we can see here. Just going to edit that a bit and zoom in just a little touch there. There we go. Maybe back just a tad, a little. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so now I can go real or fake. Okay, and then it fakes the right answer. I can even add a little comment just in here. You see that? So if I just click on that little commentary here, I can then type in, you've guessed correctly, this animal does not exist. There we go. If you said it was real, and it goes, what type of creature do you think this is? You know what I mean? What would you call it? There we go. So there we go. So that's the correct answer. And then you would go on and on and on and on, you know, doing that. One good thing as well you can add with a quiz is maybe if you want to get the person's name, you can add that in the form of a question. So if I just sort of add new, this is going to be text. Just type in, please enter your full name. There we go. That's good. And then that's a long answer. Let's say that's required. There's no points for that. So I can just get rid of the points for that. That's great. But I'll use these buttons just here, particularly this one just here, so that I can move that up to the top. And so that's top. So here we go. So this is called the craziest animals. It's worth the full name is this one here. And then I've got the chow chow. Here we go. That's worth 1 point. And then this one here, and that's worth 1 point. And there we go. That's great. So there we have our quiz there. So that's actually opened up on the browser. So let's swap back to PowerPoint. Okay. And then we'll see in PowerPoint how this is affected. So What we're going to do is firstly go back to PowerPoint. Just going to click on the bottom just here. Now I can actually see this one here. It's quite common. Something went wrong. So I don't want you to panic here at all. I will say that this does happen a lot when you're working with forms, Microsoft Forms in applications as well. So don't panic. We'll have a quick look at how we can do this. So the first thing we need to do is go back to the forms and allow it that anybody can access this form, not just people within our organization. So if we swap back to our browser here, and then I'm gonna click on this little ellipsis button, top right-hand corner, just here. I'm gonna go down to settings and click on settings. And then where it says anyone with the link can respond, that's what we're gonna click on. Oops, sorry, let me just go back and do that again. Okay, so anyone with the link can respond. Make sure that's selected. That's great. I can click away to get rid of that menu. That's fine. Swap back to PowerPoint just here. Okay, and then we're going to click on this tiny little button just top right hand corner. So if we go there and click on that button top right corner and go down to and choose reload. So we're going to reload the form, and now our form should be available in PowerPoint. Great. Remember that thumbs up button? Yeah, if you got something out of this, if you knew this already, fine, that's right. You can fast forward to the nitty gritty. Great, so now we can go through this. This is really cool. I mean, say for instance, as I'm going through here, I inserted it on this one here. Maybe I was on the, I inserted it as the wrong slide here. Oh, that's fine, I can just delete that. So now I'm on here, I can just click on Shift F5 on the keyboard. Do you remember Shift and F5? Yep. On the keyboard, starts the presentation from the current slide, just like you're clicking the button in the bottom right-hand corner, yeah? So, what breed of dog is this? I can now click, and it now takes me to Microsoft Forms, where I can enter my answer. I can enter my username here, and type in Simon, and then I can say, what breed of dog is this? And I can choose my Chow Chow, that's good, and I can go to the next slide, and then, you know, go on from that one there. So if I keep going on, and yeah, you can sort of see just different ones there. Where's my real? Oh, I can't see my little, my real or fake. Let me just undo a couple of times here. Undo, undo. Oh, there we go. I think I inserted it on the wrong one. So let's just try that one again. If I go up here, there's the craziest animals. Let me just insert that form here. That's better. So that's good. Now, as you can see, it's probably best if I put that form after these two. So when I go through the presentation, say for instance, if I just F5 go through that presentation, I click, what breed of dog is this? Real or fake? So I'm going through that, and now I go to the form so I can then answer those questions here. So I can type my name and then mention that's a chow chow there. And then I believe that's fake. Click on submit, and then the answers will be submitted. Great, excellent. So just while you're on this here and this form, takes a little while to submit, I will admit, but you can then review the results and see if you got them right. Yes, you can. And you guessed correctly, that's great. So I can then go to next slide, and now I'm on to this one, and I can go and I can add another form in there. Okay, brilliant. So just one quick thing with this, I will show you, just to get an inkling of how you would get those results on a basic level. So if I come back out here, now if you haven't already done so, you can download the, there's a nice little picture there. I've got my Office shortcut there with a little app shortcut where I can go to Forms online. Oh, in fact, because I was already online as well, I could just click this button here. See, I can access my Forms. So where I've got, what do I call it, the craziest animals, I can click on that. And then I can see my responses here. If I wanted to see them, I can click on this button that says open up in Excel. So I can click on open up in Excel. This will then open it or download it into an Excel spreadsheet. You can see I've got the craziest animals. When I click on save, it will download it into an Excel spreadsheet, and then see if I can just show you that spreadsheet on the screen. It's pretty cool. So it's just loading up now. 5, 4, there we go. Let me just drag it to the other screen so you can see. And it's gone into a form of a table here in Excel. There you go, table one, and you've got this here. Brilliant, really good. So there are a couple of downsides to this. Let's just talk about them because that's what we're gonna address next week. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. So let me just say, close that one down here. Say for instance, I run my Microsoft PowerPoint presentation again, and let's see, we do it online. Yeah, there's normally a little bit of problems when we do this online. So let's just take a plunge, shall we? So I'm just going to click on slideshow just here at the top and then present online just over here, okay? I'm going to go to make sure they can download the presentation just in case there's any issues at all. And then I'm going to click on connect and it will present this online, push it to its PowerPoint online servers, wherever they happen to be. And I will be able to present this remotely, and then we'll have a look and see what the users are seeing remotely. I've done this already on a previous video, so if you haven't already done so, please have a look at that. I'll make sure the link's available. Great, there we go. This link I can share, brilliant, or I can just click on copy link here. So I'm going to click on copy link. I'm going to go back to my browser and I am just going to paste. And that's it, and pretend I am a delegate. I am somebody, a user, somebody who's experiencing the quiz. As you can see, it's saying I'm waiting for the presentation to begin. So let's make sure we begin it. Just going to swap back to PowerPoint here. Just going to click on start presentation. And then what I would do is I'm going to swap and pretend to be a user. Okay, so let's pretend to be a user. So I'm just alt tab to swap back to, swap to the browser. And I'm going to click on the buttons to go next. I'm not following the presenter. I can go next. And I can reallocate when I go next. You see what happens? It takes me to the actual quiz. And what I can do is I can actually enter my name in here. That's good. Here we go. Let's see. I'm the second. Simon Cubbin the second. There we go. I can say this is a chow chow here. And I can go down and I say, I'm going to pretend to get this wrong and say, we'll submit. So now I'm interacting with this as the presenter, he or she is going on doing their own thing. Now I'm interacting with this. I can still view the results, see if I'm right or see if I'm wrong. I can see, oh, I've got this one wrong. Let me just zoom back a tiny bit so you can see. Yeah, there we go. Brilliant. Excellent. And then I can go through this here. Great. So the downside with this one is you think, okay, that's fine. Let's just go and stop that presentation here. So I'm just going to come out of it and click on the button at the top here that says end online presentation. And that's good. Let's exit that one. Now I'd want to sort of see the results for that form. Yeah. Now if I go back to Microsoft Forms at the top, let me close that one here and go to Microsoft Forms. Okay, you can see I've got my two responses. So I've got this page here, which is great. I can bring it together. But when I go to open in Excel, just here, like so, okay, it opens it up in Excel. You see I've downloaded a separate file. If you look very carefully at the name of the file, it says the craziest animals 1-2. So that means I've got two responses. And then when the third one happens, or the fourth, or the fifth, or whatever. So the idea is, this is great for a form where I want to get quick results on. Maybe I'm presenting and pretty much there's 20 people watching the presentation and I want to get everyone's results together all nice and download it as an Excel file. No problem. But say, for instance, this is a more ongoing quiz or a presentation I'm just putting on a website somewhere, or a quiz I'm putting on a website somewhere, and then I want them to, at their leisure, go and fill in the details. You know, I'm going to have to wait for ages to keep downloading files. And I might download a file, say my boss says, I need updates right now. I download the file, and then I got, somebody else now adds somebody else, you know, adds a response or fills out the form. But the problem there is that makes another Excel file. It all downloads as separate files. So what we'll do next time is I'll show you just a little trick of how to get it all collated in once so it all populates a file. So it's a bit tricky, that one is. So if you tried around with that, and I've had a look at a few forums as well, and I think I've got the answer. Brilliant. So just hope you got something out of that. I'll save that one. So I hope you got something out of that. If you have done, please give us a thumbs up. If you haven't already done so, please check our live online training. So at the moment, we do Excel and we do Power BI as classes, but we do PowerPoint as well and many other different programs. So please have a look at computertutoring.co.uk, have a click on live online training, and then you'll see all the different courses that we do. Hope you're okay. I hope you're enduring through this time of isolation. Hopefully it won't be too long. So I just want to say thank you so much for watching and take care, guys.